Well, friends, we're gathered together in the sight of God to witness and bless the joining together of Adriel Martinez and Gabrielle in Christian marriage. The covenant of marriage was established by God, who created us, male and female, for each other. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they now are no longer two, but they will be one flesh. This is a great mystery through which God gives us the glimpse of his everlasting covenant, his commitment to those who join themselves to his church through faith and baptism. And now, Adriel and Gabby, you have come to give yourself to one another in this holy covenant. I ask you now in the presence of God and these people to declare your intention to enter into union with each other through the grace of Jesus Christ, who calls you into union with himself as acknowledged by your profession of faith and baptism. Who gives this woman to be wed?
A river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Won't take my hand, take my home. For I can't help falling in love with you. Oh, for I can't help falling in love with you.
Today, I stand before you, our friends, our families, and God, and overwhelmed with gratitude and joy. I remember how God made our paths cross the first time we met, and I knew that she would be in my life forever after that. I remember the first time I knew I loved you, and it was kind of soon, but I thought I was crazy. And I told my best friend, I was like, I think I'm really in love with him. And she was like, you've hung out with him twice. And I'm like, I know. But God told me you would be in my life forever. And it's funny to look back at how right we were about each other and how much we loved each other. Adriel, I love everything about you. I've battled a lot in my life with feeling rejected and just not being everybody's first choice. And with you, I always feel like I belong. Every time I'm with you, anytime I'm with you, I feel like I'm home. You're my best friend, my partner in crime. You've changed my life in ways that I never thought were possible. And I feel like I'm a better person ever since you came into my life. Every time we're together, I feel like you bring out the best in me. And I appreciate the man that you are, and the man that God created you to be, and the man that your parents raised you to be. And I vow to cherish you, to honor you, to be submissive to you, and to be the woman that you deserve. I love you.
Ephesians chapter 5, verse 31. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. Gabriella, from the moment we met, I knew you were different. I didn't know what it was. I thought it could be your gentle kindness in the way that you acted, or maybe your radiant joy in the way that you smiled. At the time, I didn't know. But what I truly didn't know, after some time of being with you, was that I wasn't just attracted to your looks or your personality. What attracted me is your love for God. I recall our first conversation just trying to figure out what I was feeling towards you. Maybe I was too naive or too young to know at the time, but I know God's timing is perfect. What truly made me realize you were going to be my wife was who you brought out of me. Gabriella, my hope is that every man here today has found or will find a woman half as beautiful as you, because your role in my life has been immeasurably impactful. I thank God for you every day, because every minute that I've known you, I can look in the mirror and see a better man. Thank you, Gabriella, for making me a better man. Thank you for bringing me closer to God than ever before. Thank you for endlessly caring for me, putting up with my fits, my attitudes, and my bad days, which there's a lot. I hope to give you everything you deserve in a man, and you are a woman that I will never stop trying to impress, to please, to win over, and most of all, to love. Proverbs 18, verse 22, he who finds a wife finds what is good and receives favor from the Lord. In my youth, I never intentionally sought a partner, nor did I engage in meaningless relationships, and the odds of our paths crossing were never likely. But with the grace, guidance, and perfect love of God, through all of our adversities and odds, tribulations and struggles, I have found my wife. Gabriella, before all our loved ones here today, I profess my devoted and faithful love to you, that I may honor you as a husband, and that I may always be the shoulder that you can cry on, the ear that you can bend, and the lips that you can kiss. I devote this new marriage to Christ, that no other than his hand may guide it to fulfill the will he has for us. I pray before my God that he leadeth me to be the man he made me to be, a principled but open friend, a strong but wise leader, and a firm but loving husband. Finally, I just want to say, for being my partner, and now for being my wife, I love you with all my heart from now until forever, Gabriella.
Wow. Now that Adriel and Gabrielle have given themselves to each other, in the presence of God and exchanging of vows and rings, I pronounce that they are now husband and wife. In the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit, you make yourself
unforgettable. That's what you are. Unforgettable. Though near or far, like a song of love that clings to me, how the thought of you does things to me. Never before has someone been more unforgettable in every way. And forevermore.
Well, all I've got to say is I love you two. You two are perfect for each other. We're always going to be here for you.
I just want to say congratulations to you guys too. I'm excited to cry, but seeing your guys' marriage is just such an honor.
For you, the marriage that will make memories that last, well, you know, stuff like that, that hope will not smell after that.
Unforgettable too.